computers in any form are becoming such a big part of our lives that we cannot even keep up with it, right? Like, it's like every new day there's something new, right? It's exciting, and our children are growing up in these worlds surrounded by them. So I think if you see these days, it's not anymore like when we were children, in which was like, okay, are you going to go into a career in computer science or you're not, right? But the limits are completely blurry, you know, you don't even know what is anymore computer science and what is not, you know, or you might end up landing in a job, you know, which suddenly you're doing more computer science than, you know, the person next to you who actually went into computer science, right? So all is changing so fast, right? And here I want to tell the story, like, which was fascinating for me. So I went into, originally I was an architect, right? And I switched careers in 2013. Right. And then to look for a job in a career in tech. Right. And then the way that I looked for a job for the first time as a programmer was I asked, OK, so here it is what I have in my hands. I can actually choose for the first time in my life in which industry I want to go. As a programmer, there are jobs for us everywhere, you know, and for me that at that time was education. So for me it was like, okay, I'm only gonna send out CVs, you know, in education, right? So I think that's, I mean, there are so many options, you know, like to choose from. So I think that's on one hand. And then the challenge for us right now, what you're referring to about how is that possible, right? Like the challenge in our hands is to say, how are we going to communicate that to our children? We are doing something wrong, right? It looks like based on the numbers, right? So it's like we need to find ways in which we can really communicate to them that, look, understanding computers and how they work, it's really a superpower.
It is. You know? But also, I think making tech really exciting, like COVID has really given us something to think about right now. So every business is online. If you're not online, you're not going to be successful right now. Everyone's pivoted. And
yes,
you know, when we weren't going into work, when our offices shut down, everyone was like, oh my gosh, our lives have come to a standstill. What are we doing? But our kids or everyone was watching Netflix, and it's all driven by technology. And what I say is stop and think about who is behind, who is powering this technology. So we're booking our holidays online. Who is powering it? You know, somebody is sat behind there and they're developing code or they're developing systems for us to be able to access all this exciting technology. Yes. I remember when my, you know, my children during COVID, they were so excited that, you know, they can order Nando's online. And, you know, you say to yourself, it's an app. Who is developing this app? And so then it makes things really exciting. Yes. And I think that's what we really should be looking forward to. And we should tell children and parents that this is our future. It's only going to get better. Can you imagine what the world is going to look like next year or the year after? It's so exciting.
Yeah. I have to say, like, I want to mention briefly, but I have to say that, I mean, I'm very positive as well. And I'm very optimistic by nature, right? But this weekend, I was watching The Social Dilemma, which is this new documentary on Netflix, right? And well, that's a great example of what you're saying about you get to see that are really true people behind all these apps and, you know, anything, any tool that we are using at this moment. Go and watch it. Great insights. What I want to mention, though, is something that I loved from Cathy O'Neill, which is a data scientist in that documentary, and the definition that she gave about algorithms. She said algorithms is nothing more than opinions embedded in code. And I thought that was so beautiful. And then suddenly, I started thinking, like, look, we really need as diverse as possible these teams, you know, making those decisions, you know, and then, you know, wrapping it in this code, you know, to be really like the world needs us, you know, like it cannot be that it's only 17% of women in those teams at this moment making those important decisions for our lives.
Yeah. And they're actually developing the algorithms behind the tech we're using. So if women aren't being included, they're not going to service the community that who's using this tech in the first place. So that's why we need women involved.